Dear friends, this is Prithivi Raj from Bangalore connecting with you once again through this short message on greed. In Matthew 27:5, we read as, Judas threw the money into the temple and left. Then he went away and hanged himself. This is the tragedy happened to a person who failed to control greed, though he was a disciple of Jesus, witnessing extraordinary teachings and miracles in his life. In Ecclesiastes 5:10, we read as, whoever loves money never has enough. Whoever loves wealth is never satisfied with their income. Greed drives us to seek more and more and makes us dissatisfied with what we already have. There is nothing wrong with pursuing a dream and working hard to become rich and successful. But at times, that pursuit can become a single-minded desire for wealth, dictating every aspect of our life. Money is a good thing, but greed attached to it lands us in misery. In Luke 12:13-21, we read about a parable narrated by Jesus Christ to highlight the negativity caused by greed in a person's life. He highlighted how a person who stores up treasures for himself will not be rich in what matters to God. He warned us to be watchful and to control greed in our lives. In Ephesians 5:5, we read that greedy person has no inheritance in the kingdom of God. Greed can be defined as the excessive desire to acquire or possess more than one's need. Dr. Billy Graham, in the book of Seven Deadly Sins, says that greed has two cousins. The first one is covetousness, the desire to own what is possessed by others, and the second one is jealousy, the resent over the blessings or the good fortunes of others. We notice two types of greedy persons. One is extravagant, making a show of his possessions to impress others. The other is a miser who has a lot of money but hoards it and delights in counting it but not using it. Our greed may be because of the fearful need to store up surplus goods so that we will have so much for our future needs. Greed also can be the obsessive desire for more money and material goods to achieve the social status, authority, and power that comes with it. Greed has the tendency to destroy our health, family, and relationships in our life. At times, greed forces us to take shortcuts, careless risk, and to get involved in illegal, unethical, and immoral activities. Greed has the potential to take us captive and to destroy us completely. Greed is the most socially accepted sin in our culture, but as children of God, we are advised in Hebrews 3:5 to keep our life free from the love of money and to be content with what we have. Some of the practical tips for keeping the greed in control are: focus on what is important in life, like our spiritual welfare, our health, our family, etc. Be content with what you have. 1 Timothy 6:6 suggests that contentment and godliness leads to more gain in our life. Be generous. Generosity is the antidote to greed. Being generous helps to unloose our grip over things of the world. do not worry about future. We cannot control everything in our life. God is our shepherd and He can be trusted for our needs of today and tomorrow. Detaching ourselves from worldly goods would make our life simpler, happier, and more effective. Let us pray. Father, we understand your warning about the love of money being the root of all kinds of evil. Help us to repent and exercise control over our uncontrolled desire for possessions, properties, and power. In Jesus' name, Amen. Thank you for listening. God bless you.